Hello students, I hope you all are doing good. I am Manoj. This is Study with Sir Manoj, your digital classroom. I'm getting your replies. You can see on your screen. Keep watching, keep learning, and enjoy today's class.
So in the previous method, I explained different ways of defining a function. Out of three, only I have explained the first method, program with syntax. Today we'll do more program based on the first method, that is receiving value and returning outcome to the caller. So here are the two questions. Write a program using a function palind to check whether the entered number is palindrome or not. The method should return a value. Palindrome means, you know, if you reverse a number, you will get the same number. For example, 131 222 909. If you reverse 909, you will get 909. Okay, so these are the palindrome numbers. Number two program, program using a function chk prime to check whether the entered number is prime or not. Here also the method should return a value. So the method to return a value means the first method, that is receiving value and returning outcome to the caller. Okay, prime number means the number which are having two factors. So this is the program of palindrome. See, as per the syntax, I did first package, then class, then declare the prototype, then the variables, while loop logic, return statement is there, then the main method, scanner class. Okay, so see here, public int palind is the prototype, that is calling part, calling method. So who is calling here? Val equals to pl.palin is the caller. Okay, so when the user will enter a number, it will store in n, then with the help of this object it will call the palin function, so that n will go to num, the value will store in num, then it's come to the while part, it will check. So here rev will store the reverse number. So after that, the return statement will hold the value and go to the main method, then will check val equals equals to n. It means n is the original number and val the reverse number. Okay, so this is the logic of palindrome number using a method palin. Clear? Okay, the next program, check prime. So the method name, you have to check public int chk prime int num. Here also int chk prime is the calling method. Okay, return statement is there. Then the caller method is chk prime n. Okay, so actual parameter will go to the formal parameter. What the user will enter, that will store in n, and that l will copy to num. Then the logic will perform. Then the value will return to the main method. Then it will check. It means when you will do a program using function, it divides the function into two parts. Calling, that is formal, caller, actual. In calling, just write the logic. In caller, input, checking part and output. Okay. Now we'll do this in BlueJ. So palindrome, the program, I import Java class, just try at home. Okay, now compile down, you see, yes, no syntax error. Then close, right click on palindrome, click on void main, so that you can see the method call void main string. Click on OK, so that the terminal window will appear. Here one message display that enter a number. Suppose the user will enter 256. Enter, what will happen? It is not a palindrome. Why? Because you will reverse, it will come 652. So 256 is not a 652. Clear? So now we'll enter another number and we'll check whether that is palindrome or not. Say 909. I have entered. Enter. It's a palindrome number. Understand? So if you'll enter a number and you will reverse, the number is coming same, that is said to be palindrome number. That is using method. The next one, prime. Comment statement better to write, because the user can know what is the program, the question of the program. Okay, so I have used the variable int IEC return, main method is also there. Okay, both calling and call, then compile. Yes, no syntax error. That means the program is correct, error free, void main. Okay, message display enter number, suppose 36. Tell me 36 is a prime or not. Okay, it's not a prime number because 36 says more than 2 factor. So now we'll enter a number, we'll check whether that is a prime or not. Say the number 19. Say the number 19, void main string. Okay, the message will come, enter a number 19. Yes, it's a prime number. Understand? I hope the doubt is clear. So this is the way to do program using method palindrome and prime. So here are the homeworks for you. Program using a function armstrong to check whether the entered number is armstrong or not. And the second one is using function check perfect or not. Okay. Okay, have a nice day.